Look at that man, the ball was right in front of him! Why is he running past the ball? What's going on, everyone? It's the True Geordie, back again with the FIFA 16 Newcastle Courier morning. In the first episode, we made a great start of the season, getting two wins and a draw. However, in this episode, the quest for silverware starts with our first game in the Capital One Cup and also followed by a massive game against Arsenal. And standing in our way in the Capital One Cup is Hull City. One man to watch out for will be Abel Hernandez, who's very quick up front and can pose a danger at our defence. Also, the man who's on loan from Arsenal, Chuba Akpom, is lightning quick, and I'm a bit worried about this because I'm having to make replacements in me defence. With Arsenal coming up in just a couple of days, I can't afford to play me full strength team against Hull, so in goal is Darlow. A bad four of Dummett, Lascarles, Taylor and Sterry. In the midfield, it's Marvo, Colback and De Jong, and going forward, it's Rolando, Ahrens, Obertan, and up front, it's Ayoze Perez. In the middle, to Marvo. Into Perez, into Rolando, Ahrens, just wide. Oh, they fucked up rightly here, lads. They fucked up. Obertan puts it on a plate and it's saved. Sam De Jong, what can he do? Come on, De Jong. He's got a decent shot on him. Usually, oh, what a strike, my son. 1-0 and Sam De Jong making a case to be put in the first team. Get in. It's punched out to De Jong. He takes a touch, makes a little bit of space and then just curls it in. It looked like it took a deflection, but I don't think CM De Jong would want anyone noticing that, so let's just... I didn't say it if you didn't, mate. Oh, there's been a sending off. It's Robertson. He was fouling, and then he just kicks us right in the fucking back. I mean, you could argue we got the ball, but he must have went through us. Right, well, on the counter, yeah. We can go. We've gone. Come on, Perez. Come on, son. Finish it off nicely. Come on. Back post. Oh, shit. Shit. Oh, shit. On the... Oh, fucking hell. It's a good job I'm 1-0 up, otherwise I'd be losing my fucking mind right now. And that's it, it's full time. We've got off to a good start in the Capital One Cup, but now it's time for the real game. Time for Arsenal at home. In my opinion, Arsenal's best player has to be Alexis Sanchez. He's constantly pressurising you. He can shoot from anywhere, he can score from anywhere, he can create all kinds of goals. He is definitely a danger man. Another one to watch out for has to be Mesut Ozil. He's going to be the creator, the one who's trying to put it on a plane for the strikers and make it impossible for them to miss. And as you can see, we are back to full strength. Everyone is well rested after the night off in the cup. It's Krul in goal, Haidara, Colaccini and Bemba Yanma. In the midfield, it's Anita, Chiotti, Sissoko, and going forward, it's Tovan, Wijnaldum and Mitrovic up front. Oh no, no, it's Walcott. It's Walcott. I said we needed to watch out for him. He's turned provider. And luckily, Danny Welbeck, he fluffs his line so much he should be called Belwick, has missed. Get the tackle in. Aaron Ramsey pulls it back. Oh, Ramsey's skinned work. Ramsey's played it straight through to Rosicky. Put it. No, no. Oh, you cunt. Fucking Belwick, isn't it? Look at the gaping hole in the defence. And Bemba, it was my fault. I brought him out and that was the hole that I left open. Didn't sound right, did it? That's it. That's it. This is a good chance to counter. Come on, Mitrovic. Come on, son. Mirovic has to hit it early. And he does, but it's fucking saved. Sissoko. Inside. Mirovic. Mirovic. He sends a check to Yoni. And what a load of wank. Right. That's it. Through. Oh, Vonny is taking it on. Come on. Oh, and Arsenal winning again. Joking on you. Fucking oh, what a load of shit. Welbeck scores. Fucking bullshit. Bullshit! Danny Welbeck coming away with it again. The most overrated player I have seen on this game. It's a joke. Danny Welbeck has destroyed with. So fucking overrated. Absolute joke. Right, lads? Well, basically, we're dominated from start to fucking finish. I'm not going to lie, but Welbeck... I've they watched him play before they've given his ratings. And our FIFA ratings are always a joke, but bloody hell, mate. He was unstoppable. All right, next up in the Premier League, a chance of redemption against West Ham. And no doubt we're going to have to watch out for West Ham's main man, Dimitri Payet, who ripped Newcastle to shreds this season in real life and on the game has two goals and one assist in four games. And another player we're going to have to watch out for is former Newcastle lad Andy Carroll. He's already got one goal to his name on the game so far this season. He's a powerhouse, he's an ultimate target man, and I'm worried about Coloccini and Mbemba against this cunt. And after losing to Arsenal, I'm a bit wounded. I really want to go and try and win this game, so I'm going more attacking. I've gone 4-4-2, as always, the same back four and goalkeeper, with Sissoko and Tiotti in centre midfield. In attacking midfield, we've got Tovan and Wijnaldum, and up front, I'm trying these two together. I'll see if I've been proven right and it works or not, but it's Mitrovic and Perez. No, the space to turn into. And I've blocked it, but it's still into them. Oh, was that a 1-2 offers, like, was it? Fuck me, lads. I know we're living dangerously, but Jesus. Oh, it was a bad pass. But, oh, God almighty. If we could just pass the fucking ball, I would have been through there. And instead, Andy Carroll's lining up a shot. And, oh, Coloccini, I didn't press Coloccini to do anything. He's given a fucking penalty away. You fucking stupid cunt. I didn't press him to do anything. I wasn't even looking at the screen. What's he doing that for? Please save it. Please save it. Please save it. Please save it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, he saved it! Yes! Get in! What a save as well. Come on! It's sent through to Perez and the keeper has to come out. Come on! Come on, do that. Nah. Perfect. That's probably the best chance we've fucking had. Shows what a joke we've been this half. Inside. To Musa. Musa. Sissoko. Into Tovan. It's Tovan! It's saved! Oh, and we're fouled in the box though. Oh, I got the shot, but I was fouled in the... Oh, oh, Sissoko, look at how slow they are to react, man. I've seen me fucking nana pick a fucking spilled cup of tea up quicker than this shit. Oh, Mitrovic, out strength that easy, is he? Right, all right, all right.
All right. Yeah.
Into Cissé. Cissé, oh, God, he is shite, isn't he? Bloody hell, I've nailed him. They've nailed them on you. I hate it every fucking second of that pile of shit game, but unfortunately, it has completely exposed the massive weaknesses we've got in the team. All right, next up, after a really frustrating game, a chance hopefully to score some goals, it's Watford at home. And it doesn't take a genius to work out this one bloke we have to watch out for. It's Ibarbo. I know you've all heard of him. He's fast as fucking lightning, and if we are asleep at the back, he'll punish me. And another player who's good in the air and will score goals if we're given the chance is Troy Deeney. So let's not give him the chance. Let's go and win this fucking game. And I'm sticking with the same formation. We have to attack Watford. We can't sit back. It's at home. We're slowly slipping down the league, and I'll get to that at the end of the fucking episode. So the one change I've made is Coloccini out. His form had been slipping, and I've brought in young Lascales. I've made him Mbemba captain. Hopefully that change will shake the fucking team up. That is poor. That is poor. We're giving them space here. No, 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 no. Get back, get back. No, it's saved. Fuck me. First 5 minutes, lads, and we'll start like a bag of fucking shite. Who is this? Is this Ayoze? Ayoze Perez. Come on. Come on. I'm absolutely fed up the daylight, lads. I'm fucking fed up. This is absolutely shit. Come on, Mitrovic. Inside. Inside. Come on, Mitrovic. Can it even get the shot in? Can it even get the shot in? Because Watford are so great in defence that they've been in the Premier League for the last 20 years, winning titles, obviously. Oh, my God. Oh, my God! Fuck off! Fuck off! Bullshit! Look at that, man. The ball was right in front of him. Why is he running past the ball? I kind of capitalised on their bad touches, yet I try and take the nice, slow, piss-pass fucking football, and yet I can't even pass it round them. It's fucking Watford. Alright lads, as you know, I want you lot to be me transfer experts, me scouts for the January transfer window, and I'm looking at the side right now. I'm thinking the left back needs work. We need a centre back partner for Mbemba desperately in the midfield. We need someone who can control a game, can stand up, be counted, can pass the ball, and maybe a little bit of pace wouldn't do any harm either. Going forward, I think I'm going to move Wijnaldum to centre midfield because we need someone who is lightning quick out wide, and also up front, Mitrovic is doing alright, but he needs some help. And Jose Perez is good, but I don't know if he's good enough to be my first team Premier League regular goal scorer just yet. So if we could get someone who was lightning quick playing off of him, that would be fantastic. Get your comments in the box below. But now, let's have a look at the Premier League table. And as you can see, lads, Spurs are top of the league, followed by... Sunderland. I hope that doesn't fucking stay that way. Manchester City in third place, Chelsea in fourth, Arsenal fifth, and Liverpool sixth. So the top six is starting to take shape after six games played. Then we've got us, who are in 11th place, but we're only 3 points off of top spot. So it's not, all is not lost yet. It just feels like that because this episode has been so bad for me. Man United are under us, and looking at the bottom three is West Ham, West Brom, and Leicester City. As I said, get your comments in the box below. If you've enjoyed the video and my suffering, make us feel a bit better. At least hit that like button. Don't forget to stay subscribed to the True Geordie Gaming Channel.